ikaw ay Pedro, at sa ibabaw nitong bato ay itatatag ko ang aking simbahan.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, we gather today to celebrate the solemnity of Saints Peter and Paul, the pillars of our church, the great apostles and friends of Jesus of Nazareth. We also hold every Saturday around this time our Pilgrim's Mass. We welcome all our pilgrims. We belong to one church, the body of Christ, the community of disciples and apostles. We ask Saints Peter and Paul to grant us the grace to follow Jesus more closely and to love Him more dearly. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery, let us call to mind our sins and beg the Lord's mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the way to the Father's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the truth that will set us free. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you're our life and our resurrection. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins. Teach us to forgive one another, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King. O God, almighty Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace to people of good will. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father, amen. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace to people of good will.
Let us pray. O God, who on the solemnity of the apostles Peter and Paul give us the noble and holy joy of this day, grant, we pray, that your church may in all things follow the teaching of those through whom she received the beginnings of right religion. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, King Herod laid hands upon some members of the church to harm them. He had James, the brother of John, killed by the sword. And when he saw that this was pleasing to the Jews, he proceeded to arrest Peter also. It was the feast of unleavened bread. He had him taken into custody and put in prison under the guard of four squads of four soldiers each. He intended to bring him before the people after Passover. Peter thus was being kept in prison, but prayer by the church was fervently being made to God on his behalf. On the very night before Herod was to bring him to trial, Peter, secured by double chains, was sleeping between two soldiers, while outside the door, guards keep watch on the prison. Suddenly, the angel of the Lord stood by him, and a light shone in the cell. He stopped Peter on the side and awake him, saying, "Get up quickly." The chains fell from his wrist. The angel said to him, "Put on your belt and your sandals." He did so. Then he said to him, "Put on your cloak and follow me." So he followed him out, not realizing that what was happening through the angel was real. He thought he was seeing a vision. They passed the first guard, then the second, and came to the iron gate leading out to the city, which opened for them by itself. They emerged and made their way down an alley, and suddenly the angels left him. Then Peter recovered his senses and said, "Now I know for certain that the Lord sent his angel and rescued me from the hand of Herod and from all that the Jewish people were expecting." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The angel of the Lord will rescue those who fear him.
The angel of the Lord will rescue those who fear him.
I will bless the Lord of all times. His praise shall be ever in my mouth. Let my soul glory in the Lord. The lowly will hear me and be glad.
The angel of the Lord will rescue those who fear him.
Glorify the Lord with me. Let us together extol his name. I sought the Lord, and he answered me and delivered me from all my fears.
The angel of the Lord will rescue those who fear him.
Look to him that you may be radiant with joy, and your faces may not blush with shame. When the poor one called out, the Lord heard, and from all his distress, he saved him.
The angel of the Lord will rescue those who fear him.
The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear Him and delivers them. Taste and see how good the Lord is. Blessed the man who takes refuge in Him.
The angel of the Lord will rescue those who fear Him.
A reading from the second letter of Saint Paul to Timothy. I, Paul, am already being poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have competed well. I have finished the race, and I have kept the faith. From now on, the crown of righteousness awaits me, which the Lord, the just judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but to all who have longed for His appearance. The Lord stood by me and gave me strength, so that through me the proclamation might be completed, and all the Gentiles might hear it. And I also rescued from the lion's mouth. The Lord will rescue me from every evil threat and will bring me safe to His heavenly kingdom. To Him be glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please all stand.
Alleluia, 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 Alleluia. You are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church. And the gates of the netherworld shall not prevail against it. Alleluia, 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 Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus went into the region of Caesarea Philippi, He asked His disciples, "Who do people say that the Son of Man is?" They replied, "Some say John the Baptist, others Elijah, still others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter said in reply, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Jesus said to him in reply, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my heavenly Father. And so I say to you, you are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of the netherworld shall not prevail against it. I will give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth shall be loose in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good morning to everyone and welcome to our Pilgrim's Mass. Today we celebrate the solemnity of Saints Peter and Paul, apostles of Jesus, friends of our Lord. Pero bago pa man ng lahat, bigyan natin ng papuri, parangal at pasasalamat ang ating minamahal na Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno. Marahil ay magtataka kayo, ang misa natin ngayon ay medyo kakaiba Sa mga hindi pa nakakaalam, English ang misa natin pag ganitong oras sa Sabado. We call it Pilgrim's Mass dahil napansin natin kahit hindi Biyernes, marami ang dumarating. Many are coming from different places, even from the provinces. And we also want to consider our devotees overseas. Marami na rin, no, kahit mga Pilipino sa ibang bansa, yung mga anak at apo nila, hindi na marunong mag-Nagalog. Siguro meron kayong ganyang apo na doon na pinanganak, doon na lumaki. And we want also them, our young people, to become devotees of the Nazareno. That's why we dedicate this Mass also for them. Na kahit papaano makapag-diwang din sila, makasama sila sa Misa. So we pray for the young generations of devotees, especially those overseas, that they may still, like their parents and grandparents, experience the warmth and the fervor of the devotion here in Quiapo. And secondly, you will notice this Mass is quite different. It will be a bit longer because this is a Mass in honor of the Apostles Peter and Paul. And in a special way, we pray for Pope Francis. Ang simbahan po ng Quiapo, ang tawag natin dito ay Minor Basilica. Kaya mapapansin nyo po sa taas, may susi. At nakita nyo po, may parang payong at may maliit na kampanilya. Yan po yung mga sagisag ng Santo Papa. Sapagkat bilang Minor Basilica, ang ating simbahan din po ay simbahan ng Santo Papa. At ang Santo Papa ay kahalili ni San Pedro. Pope Francis is the 266th Pope. Tayo lang po ang simbahan na kung ating ite-trace ang pinuno natin hanggang sa mga apostol kay San Pedro. Kaya dapat ngayong araw na ito, ito'y isang ating ipagpasalamat. Ang ating simbahan, ang Katolika, Romano-Katoliko simbahan, ang tanging simbahan na kung ating iuugnay, hindi tayo nag-umpisa lang noong 1900, 1800, 1500, tayo ay galing pa sa mga apostol na pinili ni Jesus sa Sareno. Kaya nga si Papa Francisco, kahalili ni San Pedro. Kaya mamaya, huwag din kayo magtaka, kaya sabi ko po, medyo mahaba ang misa ngayon, ating sasariwain din yung ating pagsunod kay Papa Francisco bilang kahalili ni San Pedro. That is our strength as Catholics. We are united under the Pope who is the successor of Peter, and the apostles, their successors are the bishops. Si Cardinal Advincula ay kahalili ng mga apostol. Kaya yun ang maipagmamalaki natin. Hindi natin kailangan yung no, mga sariling deklarasyon lang. Ako ang sugo, ako ang anak ng Diyos, ako ay appointed na anak ng Diyos. Hindi, wala tayong ganun. Meron tayo kahalili ng mga apostol. Kahalili ni Pedro na pinili ni Jesus Nazareno. And why did we join these two apostles, Peter and Paul? They are the pillars, haligi ng simbahan. Di ba ang mga tatay, tawag natin, haligi ng tahanan. Si Jesus Nazareno, ang pundasyon, ang panulukang bato, at ang haligi ay ang mga apostol. Kaya napansin niyo po sa labas ng simbahan, yung mga estatwa sa labas ng simbahan natin ng Quiapo, yan ang mga apostol. Dahil dyan nakatayo, kaya nakatindig tayo dahil sa mga apostol. And in a special way, Peter and Paul. Why? Because to them, we see the traits of the church. Peter is the source of unity. Kaya nga kahalili ng Santo Papa, kaya tayo nagkakaisa, hindi tayo kanya-kanya. Kaya pag sinabi ng Santo Papa, sumusunod tayong lahat. Kaya 2,000 taon na ang nakalipas, nakatindig pa rin tayo. We are strong because we are united. Kaya paalala sa atin, pag nawala ang pagkakaisa, doon nag-umpisa ang problema. Kaya ngayon, kung paghihiwalay ng pamilya, ang mag-asawa, doon mag-umpisa ang problema. Doon mag-uumpisa ang gulo. Kaya sa samahan, pag nawala ang pagkakaisa, watak-watak, kanya-kanyang paksyon. Kaya pagdasal natin, kita nyo, pag ang bayan natin, hindi nagkakaisa ang mga pinuno, magkakagulo tayo, kanya-kanya tayo. Peter is the source of unity. Paul is the source of universality. Because it was Paul who went out and preached the good news. Kay Pedro, nandun ang pagkakaisa. Kay Pablo, nandun ang pagsasama. Kasi hindi rin naman pwede yung nagkakaisa tayo, tayo-tayo na lang. Hindi rin magandang pagkakaisa yon. Very exclusive. Diba, minsan ganun, delikado sa isang sama. Tayo lang, barkada lang natin. Pag may lumapit na iba, ay, huwag isama yan. Hindi ganun ang simbahan. Kaya kay Pedro, we are united. But with Paul, we are also kaya si San Pablo, lumabas. Nagpunta sa napakaraming lugar kasi gusto rin niyang isama ang iba, kasama ang lahat kay Jesus sa Sareno. Unity for Peter, universality for Paul. For Peter, it is gathering. Tinitipon tayo. Kasi mahalaga yan sa pagkakaisa, nagkakatipon. Pag hindi tayo nakikita, pag hindi ka nagsisimba, paano tayo magkakaisa? Pag hindi tayo sumusunod sa pare-parehong utos, pag sinabi, sige, kung gusto mong sundin yan, bahala ka. Hindi pwede yun. Kaya yung iba nagtataka, bakit? Ba't ba ang simbahan mapilit magkaisa sa turo? Hindi pwedeng kanya-kanya. O sige, katoliko ka, pero sige, sunod ka sa divorce. Sige, sunod ka sa abortion. Sige, sunod ka sa pagpatay. Hindi pwede yun. Hindi tayo magkakaisa pag ganun. Hindi pwedeng nagkakaisa lang tayo sa prosesyon. Hindi pwedeng nagkakaisa lang tayo sa debosyon. Dapat nagkakaisa tayo buong-buo. That's why Peter is the source of gathering. While Paul is the symbol of sending. Nakita niyo po yung galaw? Ganun ang simbahan, kaya tayo malago, kaya tayo matibay. Natitipon pero nagsusugo. Nagkakaisa pero nagsasama. And that is the beauty of Peter and Paul. And they are friends of the Lord because they have shown Jesus in word and in deed. Sa salita at sa gawa. In their lives, they have shown Jesus. And that is what brings them together. Ano raw ang sikreto ni San Pedro at San Pablo? Nakita nila kung gaano sila kamahal ni Jesus Nazareno, at nakita din nila kung gaano kamahal ni Jesus Nazareno ang lahat ng sumusunod sa Kanya. Kung gusto raw nating maging tunay na alagad, katulad ni San Pedro at San Pablo, ito raw ang susi. Discover the mercy and grace of God in you, and discover also the mercy of God in others. Tuklasin mo kung gaano ka kamahal ng Diyos, kung gaano ka kinawaan ng Diyos. Kaya si San Pedro at si San Pablo, hindi naman sila uliran. Makasalanan nga sila. Diba si Pedro, pinagkanulo niya, itinakwil niya si Jesus sa Sareno 3 beses. Si San Pablo nga, mamamatay tao. malagim ang kanyang nakaraan. They were called not because of their merits, but because of the grace and mercy of God. At ang pinakamahalaga, nung natuklasan nila ang awa ng Diyos, ito, pakinggan niyo po, pag natuklasan daw natin ang awa ng Diyos sa atin, matututo ka ding magmahal at maging maawain sa kapwa mo. Yun ang nadiskubre ni Pedro at ni Pablo. And that is why the turning point in the lives of Peter and Paul was this. When Peter, after betraying, denying the Lord 3 times, nagpakita sa kanya si Jesus Nazareno. Anong tanong sa kanya ni Jesus Nazareno? Pedro, mahal mo ba ako? Do you love me? Anong sabi ni Pedro? Yes, Lord, I love you. Anong sabi ni Jesus Nazareno? Feed my sheep. Tend my sheep. Ano ibig sabihin nun? Kung mahal mo ako, alagaan mo ang kawan. Mahalin mo ang kapwa mo. Napansin niyo yun? Hindi sinabi ni Jesus Nazareno, mahal mo ba ako? O sige, mahalin mo ako. Anong sabi ni Jesus Nazareno? Mahalin mo ang kapwa mo. Kasi kung mahal mo ako, mahal mo rin sila. Ang tunay na deboto, hindi lang mahal si Jesus Nazareno, dapat mahal mo rin ang kapwa mo. Ganon din na natuklasan ni San Pablo. When Paul was persecuting the Christians, biglang nagkaroon ng malaking liwanag at may narinig daw si San Pablo. Anong sabi ni nung tinig? Saul, yun yung unang pangalan ni Pablo, Saul. Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? Why are you killing me? Why are you hurting me? Napatanong si San Pablo, who are you? I am Jesus whom you are persecuting. Eh hindi nga nagkita si Pablo at si Jesus Nazareno eh. Paano nasabi ni Jesus Nazareno na sinasaktan siya ni San Pablo? Kasi ang sinasaktan ni Pablo ay ang mga Kristiyano. Di ba sabi ni Jesus Nazareno, ano man ang gawin mo sa kapwa mo, ganun din ang ginagawa mo sa akin. You notice that, sisters and brothers? The love for Jesus is connected in our love for our neighbor. Like Peter and Paul, they discovered, if you love Jesus, you should also love the church. Kung mahal mo si Jesus Nazareno, mahal mo din ang simbahan. Kung mahal mo si Jesus Nazareno, mahal mo din ang kapwa mo. At yun ang tunay na alagad. Yun ang tunay na apostol. Yun ang tunay na kaibigan ni Jesus Nazareno. As we continue with this Mass, let us pray for that grace. That like Peter and Paul, we may be united. Like Peter and Paul, we may live in word and deed our faith in Jesus of Nazareth. Like Peter and Paul, we may discover the love and mercy of God for us. And like Peter and Paul, we may also discover the love and mercy of Jesus in others. Saints Peter and Paul, pray for us.
Please stand.
Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sin, and I look forward for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
As we celebrate the solemnity of Saints Peter and Paul, we also observe Pope's Day. Kaya nang sabi ko kanina, pagdarasal natin si Papa Francisco, and now we hold our pledge of loyalty to the Holy Father, being a community of the minor basilica of Jesus Nazareno. God the Father omnipotent, God the Son of wisdom, God the Holy Spirit of love, we ask you, deign to listen to our pledge of loyalty. We are your children, firmly believing in your divinity and eternal providence, redeemed by the blood of the Son, vivified by the all-embracing grace of love eternal, and sustained on earth through the powerful intercession of Mary, our Queen and Mother. Hail to you, O God. Hail to you, O Blessed Trinity.
Christus vincit, Christus reinat, Christus, Christus in pena.
And to Peter, the very first mortal, whoever exclaimed with deep faith and trust, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." And to all his successors, we say with conviction and joy, "Blessed are you, Simon Peter, the rock of living church."
Christus vincit, Christus reinat, Christus, Christus imperat.
To Francis our Pope, the Vicar of Christ on earth, visible head of the Church, doctor and teacher of all the faithful, guardian of apostolic tradition, to you, Pope Francis, we pledge our love.
Christus vincit, Christus reinat, Christus, Christus imperat.
To the Supreme Pontiff of the Church, courageous leader of the nations, the very personification of the Spirit of Vatican II, and upholder of the dignity of Holy Priesthood, to you, Pope Francis, we pledge our obedience.
Christus vincit, Christus reinat, Christus, Christus imperat.
To His Holiness the Pope, tireless defender of the sanctity of the home, of the innate priceless value of human life, and of the dignity of persons, to you, Pope Francis, we pledge our hope.
Christus vincit, Christus reinat, Christus, Christus imperat.
To the visible head of Christian Church, indomitable teacher, leader and father of all the faithful, steadfast in truth in the midst of errors and misunderstanding, unyielding in courage in the midst of danger, and a most reliable beacon of spiritual light and consolation. To you, Pope Francis, we pledge our undying loyalty and filial veneration now and forever.
Christus vincit, Christus reinat, Christus, Christus impera.
Let us now bring our intentions to the Father with that same faith of the apostles Peter and Paul, with the faith of the fisherman on whom the church is built, and the faith of the teacher of so many nations. We shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our Holy Father, successor to Saint Peter, that the Lord may continue to make him a rock on which he can build up the church in our own town, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who work for life, for justice, and for peace, that the Lord shall give him courage to finish the race and to keep their faith in his divine help for their cause, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For vocations, that willing young hearts may take on the challenge of priestly ministry and the power to bind and loose in Christ's name, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For missionaries, that the Lord may stand by their side and give him strength, so that through them the proclamation might be completed and all nations may hear the good news, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are held bound, whether our sickness, addiction, or external oppression, that with all of us praying fervently on their behalf, God's angel may lead them to freedom and new life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, whose lives had been poured out like a libation, that they may be purified to receive the crown of righteousness from the Lord, the just judge of all, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In silence, let us pray for our other personal intentions. Almighty God and Father, hear the prayers of this community gathered in the faith of the apostles and helped by their intercession. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Today, in your house, we kneel down and pray. We ask for your mercy as we open our hearts to receive your forgiveness, O Lord. Lord, we lift up to you all these gifts we offer for your glory. We will eat this living bread, we will drink this saving cup, and feel your presence, O Lord. As we offer this bread, and as we bring you this wine, bless them, Lord Jesus, feed us now, give us life. Send us your Spirit, the source of our lives, and together we'll serve you with love.
Please all stand.
pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
May the prayer of the apostles, O Lord, accompany the sacrificial gift that we present to your name for consecration, and may their intercession make us devoted to you in celebration of the sacrifice. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by your providence, the blessed apostles Peter and Paul bring us joy. Peter, foremost in confessing the faith, Paul, its outstanding preacher, Peter, who established the early church from the remnant of Israel, Paul, master and teacher of the Gentiles that you call, and so in each in a different way, gathered together the one family of Christ and revered together throughout the world, they share one martyr's crown, and therefore with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please all stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, our most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles, Peter and Paul, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
As one family, let us now call on our loving and merciful Father.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, and now you're saying it to all of us here, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Lord, do not look on our sins, but look on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other Christ's peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please all kneel.
Behold Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, the source of mercy and unity. The Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world, blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. To all who will receive the Holy Communion, please say Amen. When the priest or lay ministers say Body of Christ and reverently consumes the Body of Christ before leaving at the front of the priest or lay ministers, please be guided accordingly.
Sate et finite coniam suavis est Dominus. Beatus vir visperat, visperat in Come to me, all you that labor, all you that labor and are burdened, and and I will give you rest, and I will give you rest, says the Lord. Gustate et videte, poniam suavis est Dominus. Beatus vir qui sperat, qui sperat in eo. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be ever in my mouth. Let my soul glory in the Lord. The lowly will hear me glad. Gustate et videte, poniam suavis est Dominus. Beatus vir qui sperat, qui sperat in eo. Glorify the Lord with me. Let us together extol his name. I sought the Lord, and he answered me, and delivered me from all my fears. Gustate et videte, toniam suavis est Dominus. Beatus vir qui sperat, qui sperat in eo. Gustate et videte, poniam suavis est Dominus. Beatus vir qui sperat, qui sperat in eo.
Mabibili pa rin po ang opisyal na imahe ni Jesus Nazareno. Ang mga ito po ay mabibili lamang sa ating Parish Finance Office. Pagkatapos ng misa, wiwisikan po ang lahat ng banal na tubig. Pinakikiusapan ang lahat na manatili lamang muna sa inyong mga lugar. Tanging sa Quezon Boulevard o sa Plaza San Juan lamang ang labasan ng lahat. Sumunod po tayo. Maraming salamat po sa inyong pagdalaw at pagsisimba sa Basilica Minor at Pambansang Dambana ni Jesus Nazareno. Please all stand.
Let us pray. Grant us, O Lord, who have been renewed by this sacrament, so to live in the Church, that persevering in the breaking of the bread and the teaching of the apostles, we may be one heart and one soul, made steadfast in your love, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Salamat po sa pagpunta nyo dito sa Quiapo. Ingat po kayo sa pag-uwi. Salamat po sa mga naglingkod sa misa. And thank you for all your help and support to the Church. The mass intentions, love offerings, the online donations, yung mga nagdadala rin po rito ng bigas, dilata noodles, at iba pang pangayuda. Ang simbahan ng Quiapo, we are the first, one of the first to respond if there is a fire, a calamity, and we regularly help parishes, convents, and communities which have programs for the poor. because our devotion to our dear Jesus Nazareno teaches us to be compassionate and merciful to others. At dahil nga po ito'y Pilgrim's Mass, ating kinikilala ang lalo na po ang mga galing pa sa mga malalayong lugar. Kaya mamaya, kung galing pa kayo sa Visayas at Mindanao, lapit kayo sa akin para i-bless ko kayo. At alam ko, marami rin nagsisimba rito dahil birthday nila, anniversary nila, at may dasal silang sinagot ng Poong Nazareno, nagpapasalamat kayo. Kaya welcome po kayo dito at patuloy natin bigyang papuri ang Panginoon, ang ating pundasyon at kasama mga apostol na haligi ng simbahan. A true apostle and devotee loves Jesus and the church because we are nourished and united by the mercy and grace of God. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed are you, O God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. You have given us your only Son to be our way to you. Make us follow him generously, faithfully, and lovingly. Merciful Jesus of Nazareth, you have revealed God's grace and unconditional love for us at the cross. You set your church in this world from which the true light would shine for all to see. Grant that we who enter this holy shrine may walk in your ways as disciples of justice, peace, mercy, and hope. We offer our prayers for the sick, the oppressed, the youth, and those in need most of your mercy. Hear our humble petitions. Bless these religious articles that we may be fervent in prayer and charity. As we continue our journey as your pilgrim people on earth, may we set our hearts on the road to heaven, our true home and reward, where you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has been offered. Go, bring with you the mercy and love of our dear Jesus Nazareno.
Thanks be to God.
Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, sinasamba ka namin, pinipintuho ka namin, aral mo ang aming buhay at kaligtasan. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, iligtas mo kami sa kasalanan. Ang krus mong pinamatayan ay sagisag ng aming kaligtasan. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, dinarangal ka namin. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, nilulwalhati ka namin. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, dinarangal ka namin. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, nilulwalhati ka namin.